try to find a way to walk. Lord, I humble myself before thee. I don't want to be lost. I've been taught to search the scriptures and read the word of truth. Like you said, just like you promised, I'll be just like you. How can you hear to believe? Take the time out just to read. You will find that you've been wrong. Jesus is coming to his home to take his rest in Zion. You won't get to heaven. No, 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 no. Then I know it's true.
Cause I'm ready.
Yeah. All you got to do,
just receive it.
Yeah. Open up your Bible.
You can read it.
Welcome to another edition of The Bible Speak. I'm Brother Thien, and reading for me today will be Brother Tanzel. Today we're going to deal with a lesson called Where There Is No Vision. Where there is no vision. Because how we look at life today, a lot of people don't have a good story. They look at life in a way that where there's no more goals, no more aspiration, nothing to inspire us. And they don't see the vision that the Lord have at the end of the road. So what we're here to do is show you when you don't have a vision, what happens? And when you do have a vision, what to look forward to seeing. So we're going to go to 2 Timothy, the third chapter, and pick it up at verse 16. We're going to get right into the lesson, and we're going to break down some things as we're walking you through where there is no vision. 2 Timothy 3 and 16, because we need to find out what this Bible is for. What the Lord have this Bible for us here to read? What is it for? 2 Timothy 3 and pick it up at verse 16. When you get that, brother, go ahead and read.
All scripture is given by inspiration of God.
Uh-huh.
And is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instructions in righteousness.
So this Bible, we're just going to point out the main thing, is given, and it's given by God to inspire you. It's given by God for inspiration. And inspiration drives you to do righteous. Mm-hmm. It drives you to do what you need to do to accomplish what the Lord have in store for you. And that's eternal life in the kingdom of God. Let's keep it moving, because let's give examples of what is there to inspire me to want to do what the Lord say. We're going to show you. Let's go to Titus, the second chapter. Let's go right on over to Titus, the second chapter, and we're going to pick it up at verse 1. And we're going to point some things out on our way of showing you examples of how to inspire people. Go ahead and read. Pick it up at verse 1. Titus, second chapter, verse 1. Go ahead.
But speak thou the things which become sound doctrine,
uh-huh,
that the aged men be sober,
yep,
grave, temperate, sound in faith, in charity, in patience.
Now, the elder brothers, you're supposed to be sober. That means serious about life and what it is that you want to receive out of life. Grave, temperate, patience. Be temperate, not always ready to rev up, and sound in faith. Make sure your faith is not questioned. In charity, in patience. Charity is part of love and patient with people. This is what the aged man is supposed to show. When we look at the aged men, they're supposed to have these attributes. And see, this is what inspires you when you see people like this. Go ahead and read.
The aged woman likewise.
Uh-huh.
That they be in behavior as become holiness.
And women also have a role in this. That they be in behavior as becometh holiness. Your behavior want to be holy, not always wild and rambunctious. Go ahead and read.
Not false accusers.
Not false accusers, always lying on people. Go ahead.
Not giving too much wine.
Uh-huh.
But teachers of good things.
And not always drinking. You know, sisters love, we love to get some wine in our system. It's fine. But don't be giving to too much wine. And teachers of good things, you're supposed to teach your kids good things, not bad stuff, not how to get even with somebody or how to say or do something mean or evil to someone. No, good things. The word of God, this is just and good. Go ahead and read.
That they may teach the young women to be sober,
uh-huh,
to love their husband, and to love their children.
Now, you know that the Lord always putting in this sober, because in these days, everyone want to be intoxicated or high.
Mm-hmm.
Let's cut that out. Teach the young women how to be sober. Love their husbands. That's why people don't want to get married. That's why you see a lot of brothers run from marriage, because You want a sister or a woman that have certain attributes. And marriage just seemed like something that's just thrown up in the air because we're not teaching our young sons as well as our young ladies, our daughters, to nurture and love their husbands and for the husband to love their wives. Go ahead and read.
To be discreet chaste keepers at home.
Yes, sir.
Good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God be not blasphemy.
And that's what you want. You want a sister that's discreet, that's chaste. That means she's not wild. She don't just lay around with everybody. Keepers at home that know how to cook, that know how to do laundry, that know how to do things around the house or get things done. Or if she don't know how to do it, she know how to do the things to take to get it done. So this is what you're supposed to teach our young daughters. From the older sister supposed to teach this. And when you have this, then marriage will be loving. You'll grasp marriage and you will always want to marry somebody because they have these type of attributes. Then you look forward to being married. But now people don't look forward to being married. They don't see the vision that the Lord have between the man and the wife. The man and the woman is a great thing to be a part of.
That's
when
right.
You become in this marriage. Go ahead and read.
Young men likewise, exhort to be sober-minded, in all things showing thyself a pattern of good works.
And you're supposed to show the young men how to be sober-minded. Sober-minded, not high-minded. Sober-minded. Everybody want to walk around and get high. That's all you hear about, getting high. Smoking some type of blunt. That's what the young men is on nowadays. They just got to get that quick fix. Mm-hmm. No, be sober-minded. Go ahead.
In doctrine, showing incorruptness, gravity, sincerity, sound speech that cannot be condemned.
And these are patterns you want the young brothers to have, or the young men out here to have. Because if they have these attributes, then the young ladies would want you. But some young ladies, they don't want to just get any old kind of man. They want young men that have these attributes.
Mm-hmm.
This is what you look forward to. This is the vision the Lord say people should operate within. Go ahead and read.
That he that is of the contrary part may be ashamed.
And people that's not doing right, when they see a lot of people that have these attributes, they are ashamed when they don't carry these type of attributes. See, this is what you're supposed to show people so they can see a vision on how life's supposed to be. Go ahead and read.
Having no evil thing to say of you.
And they may not like you, but they may not have nothing evil to say about you because you got all these qualities. Go ahead and read.
Exhort servants to be obedient unto their own masters and to please them well in all things, not answering again.
And not always, the Lord say a servant. A servant could be a person that works for somebody. We work for the Lord. We work on our jobs, schools, so forth and so on. Hey, not always got to give lip service or tell people how you feel or how you think things should be. That's not good. Because all you do is just cause problems.
Mm.
And it's not good for the people that's on the outside looking in, that's looking at everything you do. It's not good. Go ahead and read.
Not purloining, but showing all good fidelity, that they may adorn the doctrine of God, our Savior, in all things.
Yes, sir. You want to show in all good fidelity. That they may adorn the doctrine of God, our Savior, in all things. People don't adore the word of God in these days. Why? Because there's a lot of false prophets out here. And we're going to show you that. And they are, the vision is not clear. It's blurred. So you don't know what God has in store for you because these people that is not showing what the Lord show you, that drives you to do right, is blurred. So you don't see nothing. It's all hazy.
Right.
Go ahead and read.
For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men.
He sure has. Go ahead.
Teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world.
We are living in this present world. These are things we're supposed to carry soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. People are not doing this. They're not sober. They're high. They're not righteous. They're wicked. They're not godly. They're ungodly. You know, in this present world. So now we don't see what the Lord have out here for us. And our head starts to go down because we don't see what is at the end of the tunnel. Go ahead and read.
Looking for that blessed hope.
Yes, sir.
And the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ.
And that's what we look for. That's what we, this is what our drive is for. We looking for that blessed hope and glorious appearing of the great God, our Savior, Jesus Christ. That is why we have what the Lord tell us to do. That's why we do these things. This is our outlook. Go ahead and read. This is what we strive for. This is our drive.
Right.
This is what inspires us. This is our goal. Read.
Who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
These things speak and exhort and rebuke with all authority, and let no man despise
thee. And these are the things you're supposed to teach one another. We just read it. From the old man to the young man. From the older sister to the younger sister. Teach these things and don't let nobody despise you. And you teach this with authority. Let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. Go to 2 Peter to the first chapter. 2 Peter the first chapter, because we want to continue these examples of what to look forward for in a vision. 2 Peter, the first chapter, pick it up at verse 1. Go ahead and read.
Simon Peter, a servant and an apostle of Jesus Christ, to them that have obtained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior Jesus Christ.
Yes, sir. Paul, Simon Peter, he's a good servant and a great apostle. Go ahead.
Grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord.
And this is what we're about to multiply to you. The knowledge of God, of Jesus our Lord. Go ahead.
According as his divine power have given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness.
See, the word of God give you everything that pertains into life and godliness. So whatever happens in life, be it bad or be it good, we know the outcome at the end. So that's why we tell you these things, so you can have something to strive for. Go ahead and read.
Through the knowledge of him that have called us to glory and virtue.
And when you hear this word, he's calling you to glory and virtue. Now, in order to get to glory and virtue, you got to do certain things. Go ahead.
Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises.
Precious promises. I want to get to these promises that are precious. I want to get to them. Go ahead.
That by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust.
Now, we know that this world is full of corruption. And if don't nobody teach you that, hey, at the end of all this corruption is precious promises. And you, if you are able and blessed to make it through this corruption, that you will be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption in the world. So that means just because I'm going through this corruption doesn't mean it's light at the end of the tunnel. The Lord got something great in store. Just hold on and endure.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
And beside this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue.
So when you get involved in this thing, when you get into this race, when you get into this word of God, when you get into this walk of life, you add to your faith virtue. Go ahead.
And to virtue, knowledge.
And to your virtues, add that knowledge of the word of God. Go ahead.
And to knowledge, temperance.
And when you got knowledge, temper yourself. Relax. Don't let everything blow you up. Read.
And to temperance, patience.
And when you add temperance, now be patient. Be still and watch the Lord work. Go ahead.
And to patience, godliness.
And when you add to this patience, add godliness. Be nice. Have the fruits of the Spirit. Love, peace, long-suffering, joy, gentleness, meekness.
Mm-hmm.
These are the things that add to your walk that allows you, when you keep it, to see that God got something in store for me. I got to hold on. Go ahead and read.
And to godliness, brotherly kindness.
Brotherly kindness once you got the godliness. Go ahead.
And the brotherly kindness, charity.
And brotherly kindness, add that love, which is charity. Go ahead.
For if these things be in you
and abound. If these things be in you. Go ahead.
And abound.
And abound, that means it overtakes you. Go ahead.
That makes you that ye shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord
and
Jesus Christ.
And then you won't be unfruitful in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because even when you keep these things in the world, and you may be having it bad in life, the Lord still can bless you in this life and in this world. Go ahead.
But he that lack these things.
He that don't do or lack these things.
Is blind.
You blind. You can't see the vision of God. You don't know what God got. It's blurry to you. You have no knowledge of it. You are blind. When you are blind, can you see?
And cannot see afar off.
And can't see afar off. You can't see. Vision means you can see. If you don't have no vision, you are blind. Go ahead and read.
And have forgotten that he was purged from his old sins.
And you forget when you don't carry these things for righteous people and people that are godly and people that's trying to do this thing. If you forget this, you forget that you was purged, brought into this thing, and you forgot the vision that's at the end of the tunnel that the Lord got in store for you.
Mm-hmm.
So it goes for both. People that don't know the Lord and people that do know the Lord. We got to hold on to this thing. Go ahead and finish that 10th verse.
Wherefore the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure.
Hey, if give you do- diligence. Diligence means you got to consistently do it to make your calling and election sure. Go ahead.
For if you do these things, you should never fail.
And if you do these things, you should never fall. Never. You'll always be standing upright, and you will know what you are striving for. Let's continue. Let's go to Psalms, the 119th chapter. Psalm 119th chapter. Because we're showing you more examples to inspire you. Psalms. And that's what we need. A lot of people, they don't have nothing to inspire them. We do everything like it's there is no tomorrow.
That's right.
When we go into graduations out of eighth grade, we do it as if our child is never going to graduate again out of high school. When it's prom time, we're doing it as if they're graduating out of college. Because nowadays, the young people are dying at such an early rate in life.
Mm.
We do things as if there's going to be no tomorrow. But the Lord give you hope. As long as you got breath, there's hope for
That's
tomorrow.
Right.
Go ahead and read Psalms 119 and verse 97. Go ahead.
Oh, how love I thy law.
I love thy law. Go ahead.
It is my meditation all the day.
It is my meditation all the day. Psalms 119 and 97, right? Go ahead and finish it.
Thou, through thy commandments, hast made me wiser than my enemies.
See, the commandments make you wiser than your enemies. You know what the Lord got in store for you. And that's why you will love his word. Once you read his word, you see his vision, and you start to love it because it's something good in store for you. Go ahead.
For they are ever with me.
Yes, sir.
I have more understanding than all my teachers.
You'll have more understanding than your teachers who taught you. Read.
For my testimonies are my meditation.
See, the Lord's word is what you should meditate on. Go ahead.
I understand more than the ancients.
See, hey, the word of God, the Lord will teach you things more than what?
The ancients.
More than the old, the elderly. Go ahead and read.
Because I keep that precept.
When you keep the laws of God and you know what the Lord has in store. Go ahead.
I have refrained my feet from every evil way.
And you take away yourself from all the evil ways and things that's out here that's deterring you from doing right. Read.
That I might keep thy word.
That you might keep what?
Thy word.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
I have not departed from thy judgments.
Uh-huh.
For thou have taught me.
Yes, sir.
How sweet are thy words unto my taste.
See, this word of God is sweet to your taste. When you really sit down and read it, then you get the vision of what the Lord has in store for you. It's sweet. Read.
Yes, sweeter than honey to my mouth.
Sweeter than honey to your mouth. You know honey is pretty sweet. Go ahead.
Through thy precepts, I get understanding.
You understanding that this world has an end to wickedness. Go ahead.
And therefore, I hate every false way.
And now you hate every false way because you don't want to be involved in nothing against God. Go ahead.
That word is a lamp
it's a
unto
lamp.
My feet.
And to your feet. It's a lamp. That means when you look down, it's light to where you're supposed to step in darkness. Go ahead and read.
And a light unto my path.
And it show you the light on where you should travel. Take this route. And at the end of here, you're going to get to your final destination. Let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. Let's go to the book of Job, the 33rd chapter. Because this is the vision that comes at night from God, right?
Mm-hmm.
You talk about at night, right? Because we talk about he meditated on this day and night, right? Job 33, and pick it up at verse 18. We're just showing you things to keep you your drive going until you so it can inspire you. Job 33 and 14, when you get that, brother, go ahead and read.
For God speaketh once, yeah, twice, yet man perceive it not. In a dream.
In a dream.
In a vision of the night.
See, this is the vision. This is when the Lord started to put things in your mind. The vision. He giving you what he wants you to do. Go ahead.
When deep sleep falleth upon men.
Yes, sir.
And slumbering upon the bed.
Uh-huh.
Then he opened the ears of man.
Yep.
And sealed their instructions.
See, when you listen to this lesson, he opening your ears and he sealeth your instruction on what you should do in life. Now you see. You see. Go ahead and read.
That he may withdraw man from his purpose.
And he withdraw you from your purpose, what you thought you wanted to do in life. No, I got something better for you to do. Go ahead.
And have pride from man.
Uh-huh.
He keepeth back his soul from the pit.
He keepeth back your soul from going down to the pit. Go ahead.
And his life from perishing by the sword.
And see, he protects your life. So you're not out here dying like everybody you see around you. Because he got a purpose for you. Now you know your purpose. So you don't get into things that's going to take your life away quick.
That's right.
Now you have something to motivate you, to drive you. Something that you can set goals to reach. Let's keep it moving. That was the end of Job?
Yes.
Let's go. Let's go to Numbers, the 12th chapter. Let's back on up to Numbers 12 and pick it up at verse 6. Numbers 12 and verse 6. When you get that, brother, go ahead and read.
And he said, hear now my words. If there be a prophet among you, I, the Lord, will make myself known unto him in a vision.
Uh-huh.
And will speak unto him in a dream.
Yep. Now, the Lord said, if it's a prophet among you, He said, the Lord will make myself known unto him in a vision. The Lord is making himself known unto me in a vision as I read his word and will speak unto him in a dream. When I read this word, I'm dreaming about righteousness.
That's right.
You know, sometimes you think the Lord put things on your mind. It ain't that the Lord talking to you. He putting things on your mind to drive you to do righteous.
Yes,
he
sir.
Show you the good side of it and the bad side. And it's up to you to choose which side you're going to choose. But he show it to you.
Yes.
In the vision. Let's keep it moving. By the prophet, right?
Yes.
Righteous prophets. Let's go. Let's go. Let's keep it moving. Let's go to Psalm 74. You know what I'm saying? Psalm 74 and pick it up at verse 7. Go right on over to Psalm 74 and verse 7. Because, hey, nowadays when you go to church and you try to get prophesied the word of God, you're just not getting it.
Mm-mm.
Psalm 74 and pick it up at verse 7. You're just not getting it. You don't see it. You're not having a dream about nothing. You don't see the vision. You can't see it. 74 and pick it up at verse 7. When you get that, brother, go ahead and read.
They have cast fire into thy sanctuary.
See, in the sanctuary of God, they're casting fire. Go ahead.
They have defiled by casting down the dwelling place of thy name to the ground.
See, they cast down Jesus' name to the ground. Go ahead.
They said in their hearts, let us destroy them together.
Go ahead.
They have burned up all the synagogues of God in the land.
That's why people don't want to go to church, because they ain't teaching the word of God, because it ain't a lot of synagogues of God in the land. It's not. It's not a lot of Israel of gods in the land that's teaching you the Bible according to the scriptures. From Genesis to Revelation. It's not a lot of churches like us.
Mm-mm.
So it's few. Go ahead.
We see not our signs. There is no more any prophets. Neither is there any us any that know of how long.
And see, hey, he say, we see not our signs. You don't see the signs the Lord got out here. There's no more any prophet. The prophet, so if you don't have a prophet, the prophet can't tell you the vision that the Lord wants you to do. So you don't have no vision. And he said, neither is there among us any that knoweth how long. And you don't know how long this is going to go on.
Right.
How long is the earth going to be like this? You don't know.
Right.
Let's keep it moving, because we're going to tell it to you all. Let's go to 1 Samuel, the 3rd chapter. Because we don't see this no more. That's why we don't go to church. 1 Samuel, the 3rd chapter, and pick it up at verse 1. Just one verse. 1 Samuel 3 and verse 1. Go ahead when you get there.
And the child Samuel ministered unto the Lord before Eli.
Uh-huh.
And the word of the Lord was precious in those days.
See, the word of the Lord is precious in these days, it seemed like. Because
mm-hmm.
It's so much false doctrine. Was that the end of that?
And there was no open vision.
And when the word of the Lord is precious, there is no what?
Open vision.
There's no open vision. So you can't see. You can't see what to do. And it seemed like that's what's going on in these days.
Mm-hmm.
So much false doctrine out here, you can't see. Your vision is blurred. Let's keep it moving. Go to Proverbs 29. Because where there's no vision, we're going to see what's going to happen. Proverbs 29, and pick it up at verse 18. Proverbs 29 and 18. When you get that, just one verse. When you get that, brother, go ahead and read. Proverbs 29 and 18. Because we want to find out, when you don't see no vision, what happens? 29 and 18, go ahead.
Where there is no vision.
Where there is no vision.
The people perish.
The people perish. Go ahead.
But he that keepeth the law, happy is he.
See, when there is no vision, people perish. That's why people dying out here. They don't know the word of God. They see the people that's supposed to be carrying the word of God is not doing righteously. That's why they falling in the streets. Mm-hmm. Our young kids and children are dying in the street because they do not know the word of God.
Right.
They don't trust nobody. Right. There's trust issues out here.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have faith. That's what faith is. Trust me. Believe in me.
Right.
How can I believe in you when I see all you doing all these wrong things? They don't trust nobody. We don't even trust certain people. And that's what's going on. Let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. Let's go to Jeremiah 14. Jeremiah 14 to pick it up at 14. Because, hey, when the prophets don't see no more vision, let's see what happens. Because you got people out here that call themselves prophets, mm-hmm. but they don't see the visions that the God has.
Mm-mm.
But they call themselves prophets. Just like you got a lot of pastors and preachers out here. They call themselves pastors and preachers, but what vision are they seeing? Let's go see. Jeremiah 14, pick it up at verse 14. When you get there, brother, go ahead and read.
Then the Lord said unto me, uh-huh. the prophets prophesied lies in my name.
See, you got prophets out here that call themselves prophets of God, but they prophesy lies in the name of God or Jesus. Go ahead.
I sent them not.
The Lord didn't send them.
Neither have I commanded them.
He didn't command them. He didn't send them no vision at night. He ain't send them a vision and a dream. Go ahead and read.
Neither spake unto them.
He didn't even speak unto them. They always say, oh, the Lord just spoke to me. He didn't speak to these people. Go ahead.
They prophesied unto you a false vision.
They gave you a false vision. They told you, you can do whatever you want. Just believe in God. Do what you feel. God accept everybody. However you come. That's a false vision. They tell you ain't no evil going to happen to you when you transgressing the laws of God or breaking the laws of God. That's a false vision. Go ahead and read.
A divination and a thing of naught and the deceit of their heart.
See, and they give you the deceit of their hearts. They're not teaching you, thus said the Lord. Go ahead.
Therefore, thus said the Lord concerning the prophets that prophesied in my name, and I sent them not.
See, they prophesied in the name of God, but the Lord didn't send these people. Go ahead and read.
Yet they say, sword and famine shall not be in this land.
But they said, hey, all this crime ain't gonna be in this part of the land or in this suburb or in this area. They lied to you, people. Crime is eating up the landscape. Read.
By sword and famine shall those prophets be consumed.
He gonna take what's happening to the people out here in the world and consume these false pastors and preachers. Go ahead and read.
And the people to whom they prophesy shall be cast out in the streets of Jerusalem.
Go ahead.
Because of the famine and the sword.
See, it's a famine of the word of God out here.
Mm-hmm.
And the sword is devouring people. You're not telling the people what, how to hide themselves, how to keep themselves out of the face of trouble, out of the face of evil, out of the face of wickedness, because they don't see what the Lord has out here for them. Go ahead and read.
And they shall have none to bury them.
Go ahead.
Them, their wives, nor their sons.
Go ahead.
Nor their daughters, for I will pour their wickedness upon them.
Yes, sir. Ain't nobody going to be able to bury you at your funeral. Just like all these funerals that's happened. People don't even have money to bury their own dead in these days.
No,
go
sir.
Go ahead and read.
Therefore, shalt thou say this word unto them. Let my eyes run down with tears night and day, and let them not cease. For the virgin daughters of my people is broken with a great breach.
See?
With a very grievous
blow. And look
blow.
At us as a people. We broken with a what?
A great breach.
We just think we are destroyed all around the board. And our young people and our people in general does not see what the Lord have in store for us because of all this wickedness. And it's the preachers that's telling us contrary to the word of God. Finish it to the
19th. If I go forth into the field, then behold the slain with the sword.
Go ahead.
If I enter into the city, then behold them that are sick with famine.
See, it's this distress is all out. If you go in the suburbs, it's out there in the suburbs. If you're in immediate cities, it's out there in the cities. You can't escape it no matter where you go. But the preachers are not teaching this. Go ahead and read.
Yeah, both the prophet and the priest go about into a land that they know not.
And they go and take you to areas of the word of God they don't even understand. Go ahead and read.
Hast thou utterly reject Judah? Hast thou sold loaf Zion?
Go ahead.
And why hast thou smitten us?
Go ahead.
And there was no healing for us.
Go ahead.
And we look for peace, and there is no good.
See, the people ain't telling you that the Lord got healing for us. They're not telling you that it's going to be peace at the end. Go ahead.
And for the time of healing, and behold, trouble.
And they telling you, hey, you're going to be healed. No, it ain't the time of healing. It's the time of trouble. They're not teaching you this. So when you don't see these things, Your continence go down.
That's right.
Your mind is just distorted. Your thoughts is distorted. You don't have no outlook on life. You don't have no aspiration or goals. And you don't see what the Lord has in store for you. We're going to keep it moving. Was that the end of that?
Yes, sir.
Let's go to Jeremiah, the 23rd chapter, brother. Jeremiah 23. Just go right on over to Jeremiah 23 and pick it up at verse 16. Because a prophet that see a vision of their own. You got a prophet that seeing visions of their own, right? Let's talk about Jeremiah telling you about this. Jeremiah 23 and 16. Go ahead, brother.
Thus said the Lord of hosts. Hearken not unto the words of the prophets that prophesied unto you. They make you vain.
See?
They speak a vision of their own heart.
See, that's what they out here. These teachers are out here speaking a word of their own heart. Go ahead and read.
And not out of the mouth of the Lord.
And it's not after God and what he said. Is that, go ahead.
They say still unto them that despise me. The Lord have said, ye shall have peace. And they say unto everyone that walketh after the imagination of their own heart, no evil shall come upon
See,
you.
See, these preachers are saying, you can walk after an imagination of whatever you can think about and you want to do, that no evil shall come unto you. If you want to do anything contrary to what the Lord has out here in his dietary laws and what you should eat, this paganism, these pagan holidays, things you shouldn't be getting involved in, this homosexuality, instead of dealing with the opposite sex, you want to deal with the same sex. Dealing with evil people, you know they're evil and you just like them because they're good. I don't want to judge nobody. You're not judging nobody. You're just separating yourself from people that's not trying to do righteously. Because you know their end is death.
Mm.
Period. Go ahead and read.
For who have stood in the counsel of the Lord?
Who stood in the counsel of the Lord?
And perceived and heard his word.
Who heard this word? Who heard what this in the church? Go ahead.
Who have marked his word and heard it?
Go ahead.
Behold, the whirlwind of the Lord is gone forth in fury.
Go ahead. Now skip
even
down.
Even a grievous
whirlwind. Who have heard this? Who have heard this? Who have done this? Who have seen this? Nobody. Skip down to verse 21 and read. Go ahead.
I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran.
Go ahead.
I have not spoken to them. But yet they prophesy.
These prophets out here, they don't even open up the Bible. They just running it to get them a television show, to get aired on TV, to think they're doing something big in the community when something tragic happens. But they was never around to stop the tragedy. Keep reading.
But if they stood in my counsel.
If they stood in the counsel of God.
And it's called my people to hear my words.
And the people heard the word of God.
Then they should have turned from the evil of their way.
Then you should have turned, my man, from being a homosexual. The word of God turn you. I ain't got to condemn you. If he read what the thus said the Lord, it would turn him. It would turn a person that want to commit murder to not being a murderer or a thief or a liar or an adulterer that cheats on their wife or their wife that cheat on their husband. These things turn you. This is the vision you're supposed to be telling them that the Lord got out here for you. Go ahead and read.
And from the evil of their doing.
And from the evil of their what?
Of their doings.
Of their doings. You can't do what you want to do in this word of God. Skip down to verse 25 and read.
I have heard what the prophet said. That prophesies lies in my
name.
And
they always saying Jesus said. Go ahead. They'll never say Allah, Buddha.
Right, right.
Why y'all, we got to throw Jesus in the loop. Always lying on Jesus. No other God is lied on but Jesus. Go ahead.
Right. Saying, I have dreamed.
And I always got to tell you what you, I don't want to see what you dream. I don't care what you dream. Sometimes you don't even know what you didn't dream. It's been many times I woke up and couldn't remember my dream. Now you going to tell me about your dream? Give me a break. Go ahead and read.
How long shall this be in the house of the prophet that prophesies lies?
Right.
Yeah. They are prophets of the deceit of their own heart.
And they deceit out of their own heart. They make this foolishness up. Skip down to verse 28 and go ahead.
The prophet that have a dream, let him tell a dream.
If you got a dream, tell a dream.
And thee I have my word, let him speak my word faithfully.
But if you got his word, the Lord saying, this is what you're supposed to teach the people, his word faithfully. Go ahead.
What is the chaff to the wheat, said the Lord?
What's the chaff to the wheat? Skip down to verse 32. Go ahead.
Behold, I'm against them that prophesize false dreams.
They always telling false dreams, lying. Go ahead.
And do tell them and cause my people to err by their lies.
And they causing people to do wrong. That's err by your lies. Go ahead and read.
And by their lightness, yet I sent them not.
Lord didn't send them.
Nor commanded them.
And he didn't command it. If you going to church and you not reading this Bible and you not seeing the vision that God has, I ain't saying read a scripture here and there. I mean reading this Bible. Go ahead and read.
Therefore, they shall not profit. this people at all, saith the Lord.
These preachers out here ain't profiting these people because our condition ain't stopped. The crime is still heavy. Still heavy. What is it profiting? The employment rate is still high in our neighborhoods.
Mm-hmm.
Poverty rate still high. All these disease rates still high. Divorce rate still high. What is it profiting us? Because they are not showing you what the vision of God is. And you don't know what to do because you can't see. It's blurry.
Right. That's right.
Let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving, brother, because we're going to get this down. Go to Ezekiel. Ezekiel 22. Ezekiel 22, brother. Ezekiel 22 and pick it up at verse 25. Hey, because they're seeing vanity and they're dreaming lies, saying the Lord said, Ezekiel going to tell you about this too. Ezekiel 22 and 25. When you get that, brother, go ahead and read.
There is a conspiracy of her prophets in the midst thereof.
Yeah, they be conspiring against God. Go ahead.
Like a roaring lion raving the prey.
They robbing you, always taking your money. You like a prey, always getting something from the people. Go ahead.
They have devoured souls.
They devouring souls.
They have taken the treasures.
Go ahead.
And the precious things. They have married her many widows in the midst thereof.
And they making all these sisters widows because their husbands are being killed. Because they don't know how to govern their house. Go ahead and read.
Her priests have violated my law.
And you always violating God's law. Go ahead.
And have profaned my holy thing.
Go ahead.
They have put no difference between the holy and the profane.
You haven't put no difference between the holy and the profane. Between what you should be doing and what you shouldn't be doing. To be marrying women and not women marrying women. Men supposed to marry women. Not men marrying men. That is, the Lord got holy and he got profane. Teach the people. You ain't got to judge them. Teach them right. Go ahead and read.
Neither have they shown difference between the unclean and the clean.
Neither have you shown the difference between the unclean and the clean. It's things you shall eat and things you shall not eat. Period. It's things you shall do, things you cannot do. Period. Read.
And have hid their ass from my Sabbath.
And they do not keep the Sabbath, which is the seventh day of the week, holy. They don't show you this. When you see these things, I'm giving you a vision. I'm painting you a picture. Get out of there. Read.
And I am profane among them.
And Jesus is profane among these type of people. That's why I don't nobody want to come to the church. That's why I don't nobody want to read their Bible. Because they think this person read it or this person wrote it. It's crazy. Is that the end of 29?
That was in the 26.
Go ahead and finish the 29.
Her princes in the midst thereof are like wolves raving the prey.
And they ain't doing nothing but getting something from you.
To shed blood and to destroy souls to get dishonest gain.
And they destroying soul to get dishonest gain. They allowing, they telling you a sweet story so they can get your money. That's all they want. They want a sweet offering.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can do what you want. God love everybody, baby. Come on. Bring whatever you're going to bring to get dishonest gain out of you because I know you got a lot of money. So I'm going to say God going to bless you regardless of what you do because I want what you got. Go ahead.
And her prophets have daubed them with untempered mortar.
And they always daubing these lies with untempered mortar. Go ahead.
Saying vanity and dividing lies unto them saying, thus saith the Lord God, when the Lord haven't spoken.
Lord ain't even spoken. Lord speaks through his word. Read.
The people of the land have used oppression and exercised robbery.
And that's what they're doing out here. They're oppressing you and they exercise and rob you. That's why it's constant, constant prices going up. And oppression out here because I don't have enough to afford it.
Right.
Now I'm going into oppression. Go ahead and read.
And they're vexed the poor and needy.
And they're vexing the poor and needy.
Yeah, they have oppressed a stranger wrongfully.
And they oppress people that's not an Israelite. Wrongfully.
Mm-hmm.
It's hitting everybody. It's hitting everybody. Let's keep it moving. 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter. Let's keep it going, people. Because, man, I'm starting to see this thing now. I'm starting to pick it up. 2 Corinthians 4 and pick it up at verse 1. 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 1. When you get that, brother, go ahead and read. 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 1. Because we want to see, hey, Paul talked about this. Who is Saul? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Go ahead and read.
Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not.
And when you see this, he said that we don't faint when you see these things. Don't faint, people. You're going to see it, but don't faint. Go ahead and read.
But have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully.
And this is what you want to do. You don't want to handle the word of God deceitfully or in craftiness. Go ahead and read.
But by manifestation of the truth, committing ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God.
And that's what you want to do. Was that the end of the fourth verse? Read it to the four. Go ahead.
But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost.
Now, if you hid, if it's hid, do you see something? When something is hid from you, can you see it?
Mm-mm.
No. And if it's hid from you, that's because you denied it and you didn't want to see it. When they brought you this vision, you didn't like the vision. You denied it. Finish it.
And whom the God of this world have blinded the minds of them which believe not.
And when you don't believe this word, you don't believe that the Lord is talking about what's going on out here, then the God of this world, which is Satan, is going to blind your mind.